Hello everyone, this is Colin Goble. This is a demonstration of how to do some simple while loops using C++. Let's first by running the program that I'm demonstrating here. We'll compile and run the program. And as you can see, it's a program designed to add the first n integers. So first of all, if I enter, say, a negative number of -4, that really doesn't make any sense. So at this point, we're going to go into some sort of loop. As you can see, we're going to keep re-prompting the user over and over and over again until they get a valid input. Eventually, they'll come up with a valid input, say, of 4, and we'll calculate the result. The sum of the first 4 integers is 10. And the reason for that, of course, is 4 and 3 is 7, plus 2 is 9, plus 1 is 10. The sum of 1, 2, 3, and 4 is 10. So that's what the program is designed to do. Okay, now let's take a look at how the program does it. The first thing it does here is we're going to prompt the user. We're going to put up a banner to tell the user what the program does, and we're going to prompt the user to enter a value for n. We're going to read the value for n right here. And at this point, we need to test whether n is a valid input from the user or not. And as I said a few moments ago, any value less than or equal to 0 should generate an error condition. But here I've used, instead of an if statement, I've used a while loop. If the value of n is less than or equal to 0, I'm going to output an error message. But then we're going to ask the user to enter another number to try again. We're going to read the user's response. And then, instead of, as we would have done earlier, just terminating the program, we're going to return back to the top of this loop, the while loop, and ask if the new value of n, the one the user has just entered, is less than or equal to 0. If it is, then the user's entered another invalid entry, and we'll go round this loop again until eventually the user enters a number that's greater than 1, greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so this is our first example of a while loop. The code goes round and round and round in a loop until the user gets it right. When the user gets it right, we have a value of n that's greater than or equal to 1. Then what we have to do is add the integers from 1 to n. We're going to use a variable called total as an accumulator into which to add all the numbers. It's a little bit like the display on your calculator. Like the display on your calculator, if we're going to add numbers into it, we need to initialize the initial value of that total to 0. It's very, very important before we start adding things into an accumulator to set the accumulator initially to 0. We declared total up here. It's of type integer. And note that in C++, unlike some programming languages, total is not automatically initialized to 0. If we want to set total to 0, we must do it explicitly here. I is some variable, which we're going to give an initial value of 1. And we're going to ask the question if that integer is less than or equal to n. So remember, if we're trying to add the first 3 integers, say, n would have a value of 3, and I would have a value of 1. 1 less than or equal to 3 is true. So we'll execute the body of the while loop. We'll add 1 into total, because I has a value of 1, so total now has a value of 1. Plus equals is the same thing as total equals total plus I. And then I plus plus increments the value of I by 1. That's the same thing as I equals I plus 1. So I now has a value of 2. 2 less than or equal to 3 is true. We're going to add 2 into total. We increment I by 1. I now has a value of 3. 3 less than or equal to 3 is also true. So we're going to add 3 into total. We're going to increment I by 1. I now has a value of 4. 4 less than or equal to 3 is false. The loop terminates, and we print out our summary result of the program right here. So this loop here is really an example of a counter-controlled loop. We're executing the iteration of the loop a certain number of times depending on the value of n. On the other hand, this loop up here is slightly different. This is known as a Sentinel controlled loop because we're looping until a certain event occurs. In this case, the event that needs to occur is that the user enters a correct value. Okay, let's take a look at this using Bloodshed. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to click here, I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to insert a breakpoint in the program. So I'm going to toggle the breakpoint, and what this means is that when I run this program in debug mode, the program ought to halt right in the middle. It should halt right here before this while statement is executed. Let's go to the debug command. Let's run this thing in debug mode. And the program here has asked us to enter a value for n. Okay, let's enter a value of -4. Let's minimize that just for a moment and see what's happened here. Okay, so we should have entered a value of -4. So -4 less than or equal to 0 is true. So if we step this, we should see that the program executes the next step here. We'll notice that n has a value of -4. That's the current value of n in our debug window. If I execute this statement, error n must be greater than 0. The output window now has that error message there. I'll single step it again, which is here. Please try again. When I execute this statement, the program now is waiting for me to enter a value for n. So I'll get it wrong again. Please try again. Let's put in -1 this time. We go back here and notice the program has now gone back to the while loop. N is equal to -1. -1 less than or equal to 0 is true. So we'll step through this again. We'll display the error message. We'll say please try again. We'll read in a value of n. This time we'll get it right. This time I'll put in 3, say. Excuse me. I need to step it one more time. So now we're here. I'll put in a value of 3, say. And this time we're back at the while statement. N has a value of 3. Now, 3 less than or equal to 0 is false. So when I click next step, the program is going to skip the while statement and we'll halt here at total equals 0. Let's look at that. Right here is now the flow of control. So total at this point has a value of 0. Let's see if we can add that to the watch list. And so total here has a value of 0. N has a value of 3 still. And let's single step to the next statement. Next step here. At this point, I should have a value of 1. Let's make sure that's correct. So I'll add I to the watch list. I has a value of 1 because we set it 1 here. And so now the question is 1 less than or equal to 3? Notice I has a value of 1, n has a value of 3. 1 less than or equal to 3 is true. So when I next step this, we're about to do total plus equals I. So if I next step here, total goes to 1 because 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. This next statement will increment I by 1. Let's watch that. I now goes to 2. 2 less than or equal to 3 is true, and so the loop iterates. Let's just watch that happen. Click, click, click. At this point, I is 3, N's 3. The loop will iterate one more time. One, click, click. And if we next step this, for some reason it stopped there. I'm not quite sure why. Perhaps there's a bug there somewhere. At any rate, what should happen is the value of I after we've executed this I++ should be equal to 4. 4 less than or equal to 3 is false, and so the next thing that happens is the program will output the sum, will output the summary results at the end, the sum of the first n integers. And so let's take a look at that, and it tells us that the sum of the first 3 integers is 6. I'll enter Q to quit, and that concludes this demonstration. Thank you.